Without wasting any time, you wake up inside of a fever dream where Sora is simultaneously standing on this island, splashing his boyfriend Riku, and falling from the sky, until he lands on this underwater Disney princess platform and has to make a choice between the different weapons. After he does this, he fights a giant monster known as Darkseid that spawns shadows to come and kill you. Pretty standard game opening if you ask me. Once on the island, Sora helps Kairi collect some coconuts and mushrooms so she can run away from home forever, and Sora races against Riku for the chance to have sex with Kairi under the Palpu fruit tree. Yeah, sure, he thinks he won the race, but that won't stop me from beating the crap out of him under the tree. Just before we make our great escape into the vast ocean, a storm hits, and some creepy dude in a black robe comes to our island and spreads disease and famine throughout the land. Luckily, we get the power of the Keyblade, the most efficient weapon known to man, and fight this lovely fellow again. After our island gets devastated, we wake up in a place known as Traverse Town, where retired Final Fantasy characters go to beat up little kids in the alleyway. After searching long and hard for Kairi and Riku, we run into a talking dog and duck, who claim to be servants to a mouse king. Buying into this story, Sora accompanies them on a trip to find their king and his friends. Now, if you lost all your friends, where's the first place you should always look? That's right, it's all the different Disney universes. First stop is Wonderland. Kairi, you sure put on a lot of weight. Oh, never mind. That's just the queen. We take a break to save Alice from getting beheaded, then compete in a tournament at the Olympus Coliseum, because apparently saving Kairi is not that important. After beating up Cloud, we head to the deep jungle, where we meet this handicapped man and beat up an endangered species. The boss fight here is everyone's favorite Tarzan character, Invisible Lizard Demon. So after failing to fine-turn any of the first three worlds, Sora takes drastic action and heads to Iraq, where a street rat is trying to usurp the throne and steal Princess Jasmine. We help him on his quest to kill Jafar and defeat ISIS, and free the genie once and for all. Still no sign of Kairi, so Sora does what any sensible man would do, and jumps inside the book of Winnie the Pooh to help him find his honey. After successfully giving Pooh diabetes, Sora and the boys head to Atlantica, only to get eaten by the legendary space whale along the way. Sora seriously damages the whale's digestive system by swimming in his bile and tickling his prostate. Tired of his nonsense, Monstro spits him out. Alright, I'm sick of this. No, Kairi was not in Halloween Town, though Oogie Boogie activates his polymerization magic card to merge with a giant house that crumbles to the ground. No, she wasn't in Little Mermaid World, but you do get to stare at Ariel's- wait, how old is she? And no, she wasn't in Neverland, but Tinkerbell teaches you to fly, so I guess that's cool too. At this point, Sora should just give up on Kairi and let her die, let's be honest here. So, there's only one Disney World left. You guessed it, I'm talking about the world of High School Musical, where Sora must battle Sharpay in a fight to the death, to fight Gabriella to the death, to get to kiss Troy Bolton in the next musical. Then the crew heads to Hollow Bastion, where Riku picks on an oversized beast, steals your Keyblade, and steals your best friends from you. Because they only want to hang out with the cool kids. Apparently Riku stole all the other Keyblades we collected on the way, because now Sora just has this dinky little wooden sword. Sora follows Riku and turns out, Ansem, the Seeker of Darkness, is living inside of Riku, and Kairi has been in Sora's heart the whole time, I guess literally somehow? Sora then decides, screw it, I'm just gonna kill Riku, this guy's not even a good friend anyway. After murdering his best friend, Sora can't handle the guilt, and decides to kill himself, which then saves all of the princesses, including Kairi. But instead of dying, Sora turns into a little heartless, that's pretty effing adorable if you ask me. Apparently Kairi has superpowers too, because she yells loudly and then you turn back into a human. Oh, and Maleficent turns into a dragon, because why the hell not? So with Kairi saved and Riku dead, the world has been saved. Sora says some corny teenager stuff to Kairi, who then cockblocks him by saying she wants him to go save Riku. So Sora heads back to Hollow Bastion, where he fills the keyhole and gets transported to a place literally called the End of the World. Here, Sora fights Chernabog in what might be the most dated reference in this game so far. Not happy about Sora killing the only Fantasia reference in the entire game, Ansem decides to reveal himself and fight Sora, on his home island no less. Sora smacks him around, and then we fight this new and original boss, known as Darkseid. Then Ansem turns into a giant spaceship with cannons, and takes Donald and Goofy hostage. Sora flies around the screen, freeing his friends and slaying Ansem. After about 13 hours of cutscene and fight sequences, Ansem goes down, and Sora finds this random door that leads to the Shadow Realm, where Pegasus and Yugi are dueling to save Kaiba and Yugi's grandpa. Also, Mickey Mouse and Riku have apparently been hiding behind this door all along, and they say that they need to stay behind to close the door, because the door doesn't close from the front, I guess? Then Kairi tries to hold your hand, but the world separates again, and Kairi and Sora lose each other. Then the credits roll, and what the hell just happened? And that's the story of Kingdom Hearts.